It's your boy Jamar Cigar. I am currently driving from Philly, driving back to Maryland.
1 mile.
The Cookie Monster telling me where to go.
Dum de dum, dum de dum dum dum.
That's hilarious. Hey, so I'm leaving Philly right now. I enjoyed Kappa Conclave. We had it in Philadelphia this year. We'll be going to Arizona. I want to say Phoenix, Arizona in 2 years. So that's going to be fun as well. But I am smoking The King is Dead by AJ Fernandez. I've been waiting for this cigar for the longest time. And I'm driving and I was thinking, like, I haven't seen anybody, you know, talk about this cigar all that much besides people from IPCPR. And I'm excited because I love Nicaraguan cigars already. That's one of my staples in my lineup. But I love AJ Fernandez even more than pretty much everybody. I mean, it's certain brands and certain people that I'm going to vibe with. AJ is one. Espinosa is another. Placencia, you know, Room 101 with Booth. I mean, it's just a great time to be smoking cigars, and this is something that's beautiful right now. So I want to make sure I, you know, do a video on this cigar. And I don't know if I'm actually going to even go into the details of profiles and all the other stuff, because it's kind of boring when people do that to me. But what I will say is a Nicaraguan Puro, all AJ tobacco. I'm sure that him and Robert Caldwell talked about this cigar for some time. And basically what it is, it's AJ Fernandez interpretation of this cigar if it was in a Nicaraguan format. And honestly, so far I just lit it. This actually is a 46x7, and I have some torpedoes as well that I picked up, so I'm excited to see how the profiles taste in comparison to each other, because the ring gauge and the size and the way that the cigars roll, each cigar size may taste a little bit different. But so far it was indicative of what AJ Fernandez does from the beginning. It was a nice punch in the beginning. Very spicy on the cold draw. So that was fun, you know, for Nicaraguan to have a little bit of spice, a little bit of kick to it. It's kind of interesting. But overall, it's almost giving that same taste as that Tabernacle, the new Tabernacle, the revamp. Habano, I want to say it's Habano leaf tobacco from the Tabernacle, but it kind of tastes similar to that right now to me. And it could be the wrapper and everything else too, you know how that goes. But overall, very good nose feel, very good aroma. It's got a very, very good aroma to it. It's almost like a sweet smoke. It smells like, if you could smell a cigar with caramel, like a caramel smoke, it smells like that to me for some reason, like a nice sweetness to it. The retrohale is very nice, very long lasting. It will knock your socks off if that's what you wanted to do for you. It will do it. But this is going to be a fun smoke, man. But overall, I've been missing in action, and people been hitting me up like, Jamar, where are you? You won't come out no more. Honestly, man, I've been at the house. I've been trying to work on this book. The Jamar Cigar book is coming. I plan to be done with my rough draft by Christmas. That's my goal. I've been, you know, dipping and trying to think about different ideas that I'm trying to do. And I was doing way too much stuff in the timeline that I was giving. So what I had to realize is, I have to take time and make sure that I'm only putting my time into one thing at a time. And I think right now, the book is the most important thing right now for me. Once I finish the book, then it'll propel me into everything else that I have going. I've been talking to people and collaborating and trying to build collaboration with a lot of things that I'm doing. That's what it comes down to, because I think a lot of times people get so caught up in what they want to do, and they don't necessarily think about, you know, everybody want to do things by themselves. No, that's not the right way to do it. What you do is you find you a team of people, a network of people who got the same objectives and the same focuses, and you guys come together and build off that platform of you guys coming together and gaining that collaboration and that vibe and that hype off each other. Because that's what it comes down to in most ways, that's how it comes down. That's a better way to do things. And that's what I'm doing. I'm all about collaboration because cigars are all about, you know, being around other people and bringing other people into it. And I think that's one of the things in the cigar industry where you see a lot of collaboration going on right now. And I want to make sure that I'm collaborating with whoever wants to collaborate with me, who has the idea or a plan or any type of venture that is around the same thing. I want to collaborate with you. You know what I'm saying? If I hit it off with you and we vibe, let's collaborate. And I've been doing that with quite a few people. So I just say that for this video, I'm doing big things. I want to find other people who have the same mindset, and let's collaborate. There's no point in trying to do it by yourself. There's no point in trying to be selfish with it, because at the end of the day, I remember everything that happened in this journey, and I remember who said no. I remember who didn't want to collaborate, who didn't want to link up. It's cool, but take it like this. When it gets to the point where I'm booming, don't try to collaborate with me then. I want to collaborate from the beginning. We all bring each other up from the beginning. So that's what I'm about right now. So I'll tell anybody who's in the same line of thinking, in the same line of cigars, and you want to do something cigar related, holler at me. I'm on every platform that you can find, but mostly you'll see me on Instagram at Jamora Cigar. Link will be in the description below. And you can catch me on Twitter at J_Newsom1911. And that's my two platforms that I operate on. But like I said, I'm ready to do some stuff with people. Like I said, I've been off a little bit as far as I've been missing in action at night because I'm putting in 1,000 words a day. Right now, I'm somewhere near 40,000 words. I'm trying to get up to 100,000 words for this book to be done. And like I said, my timeline is for Christmas. I'll be done by Christmas for sure. And I should be getting my edits done and hopefully getting this book on the market by the first of the year, man. That's what I'm really focused on right now. So I just want to tell you guys, like I said, holler at me. I'm gonna continue to smoke this cigar. I'm sorry that it's not actually a review for this cigar, because really, what is a review? I mean, people tell you all these dumb notes of what a cigar tastes like. This tastes like earth, pepper, spice. Oh, black pepper. I've been hearing the stupidest descriptions. Oh, this tastes like white fruit. What the heck is white fruit? Like, it'd be stuff they'd be calling out that I'd be like, where are you getting these flavors and these profiles from? I mean, I have a very, very detailed palate, and I've never tasted some of the things that these people talk about. So I just sit and laugh. A cigar is going to be as good or as bad as your palate say it is. It's going to pick up things that, I guess, fruit that's not even existent, it's going to pick it up for certain people. It's just, to me, it's funny, but I don't really like to get caught up. Caught up into flavors and all that other stuff. This is going to smoke medium to full. It's a very good aroma on the cigar. It's Nicaraguan tobacco for sure. It's AJ Fernandez. That's what you need to know. And right now, this stick is a very good cigar. At this particular moment, and I don't have any doubt that it won't remain the same, if not get better. I'm a fan of Caldwell. I'm a fan of AJ. If you're a fan of either one of those guys, if you're a fan of Nicaraguan tobacco, you're going to be fine with this one. And like I said, this one is 46x7, but they do have the torpedoes as well, and the torpedo may smoke a little bit differently. So just keep that in mind as well when you're going to pick up some of these cigars, man. Right now, they're saying it's a limited production. It's only 250 boxes made at this time. So if you can snag a box, try to snag it. I'm not sure if it's going to be a running thing where they're just doing it to see how it does, or if they're going to bring it back in production again. So we'll see how it goes, and we'll see how it sells. Depending on how it sells, will probably dictate if they will make it again or not, which I'm thinking that it's going to do very well, because nothing in AJ's portfolio is bad. So I'm assuming that they'll redo this. The 250 boxes, they're going to have to do more than that, you know? But like I said, Jamora Cigar, holler at your boy. If you have any questions, you want to talk about cigars, you want to reach out, you want to link, I'm always in D.C. every single day. I live in Maryland, but if you're ever in D.C., reach out to me on social media, on Instagram, and say, hey, I want to link up. I want to smoke. Chances are, if I'm free, I'm going to link up with you. And as a lot of people can tell you, you'll see my Instagram as well, where I'm taking pictures with random people who hit me up. And we hang out. We smoke. You know, brothers and sisters of the leaf, that's what it's about. We want to link up. And like I said, let's collaborate. I'm tired of everybody trying to do everything by themselves. It doesn't work like that. We got to get this thing together. Dang, he flying. Y'all be safe. I'll talk to y'all later. Jamar Cigar. The King is Dead by AJ Fernandez. Yes, sir.